niin, aloitetaan ja jos mä saan pyytää, että FC Lahden valmentaja käy ensin peli läpi omasta näkökulmasta, kiitos.
Ensimmäinen puoliaika, ei startattaisi paljon vahvemmin. Pääsi luomaan paljon tilanteita, pääsi olemaan vahvempi kentällä. Me ei päästy puolustamaan riittävällä lähet pelaajiin, pääsi kääntymään, pääsi yrittää peliin luomaan maalipaikkoja. Ensimmäinen puoliaika oli selkeästi heikko meihin. Muutettiin muotoa puoliajalla. Terävöitettiin, pitää pystyä tulemaan lähempään ja saatiin sitä aktiivisuutta sinne kentälle. Sen jälkeen me saatiin palloa enemmän, päästiin kierrättämään enemmän ja pelattu enemmän meidän tyyppisesti. Sitä kautta päästiin tasoihin ja sen jälkeen vielä sen tasoituksen jälkeen yritetään saada yksi vaihe vielä lisää, mutta sitten meni mun mielestä enemmän aaltoilevaksi puolin ja toisin sen suhteen, että siitä olisi pitänyt pystyä vielä sitä, mitä tehtiin maaliin saakka pelatessa, niin sitä olisi pitänyt pystyä jatkaa pelin loppuun saakka. Vieraspiste, 3 pistettä lähdettiin hakemaan, toisen puolijan pelillinen ilme molempiin suuntiin ja se 1 piste, niin se on mitä saatiin tästä.
Kiitos. Gabriel, same question to you, talk us through the game as you saw it from AF side.
Feeling that today we did a great performance, and I felt that we were the first half probably dominating all the phases of the game, and we were, in my opinion, better than the opponent. And this, I felt that was the first time that I felt under control the game. But at the end, we have to be more responsible on the key actions to finish with the last pass, with the last shoot, with the last dribble, to make sure that when we have the control of the game and the control of the chances, to make sure that we can put the 2-0 and kill the game. And now I feel that two points they are flying when we deserve it, in my opinion, in big terms, the victory. But this, now we have to learn and go forward for the next one.
Thank you, Gabriel.
Otetaan Bubiastun seiska. Pystytkö se sanoa, mitä tuossa lopussa tapahtui, kun siellä oli semmoinen, miksi sitä nyt sanotaan, torikokous?
Niin. En nähnyt, olin Gabrielin kanssa menossa kättelemään ja sitten vaan näin. Lopuhässäkään, en tiedä, mitä tapahtui.
Sitten Gabrielinkaan ei nähnyt sitä sitten. Kumma juttu, kun ei kukaan oikein nähnyt mitään, mitä siellä tapahtui. Mä oon monelta kysynyt. Tämä peli muuten. Sä sanoit, että haitte 3 pistettä. Mikä tässä oli niinku parasta antia sun mielestä tässä tapauksessa pelissä, paitsi 1 piste?
Kyllä se niinku toiselle puolelle, kun me tultiin ekan vaikean puolen jälkeen, siinä kun ei onnistuttu, niin se luonteen näyttäminen ja miten lähdettiin sitten toisen puolen ajan alusta sitten pelaamaan ja aktiivisena olemaan, niin se on sitä meitä. Ja se meidän pitää pystyä seuraavaan pelin terävöittämään, että se on heti pelin alusta alkaen.
Gabriel, as you said, strong first half and maybe especially offensively, and I mean compared to the earlier matches, it maybe felt that you did something different offensively and were able to play in a different way. I mean, did you also see it that way, and why? What do you think was the difference in your attacking game today compared to other matches?
We try to compensate or to balance better the team on the sides with Kanté and with Simon. The last week with Ilves we suffered a lot because of the back three line, and today we know that Lati was used to do it the last games, and I think we balance quite well with Vaino, Simon and with Joel and Kanté. That situations, and as, after that with ball, with Etu, with Lucas back, I feel, and with Oyala that is associating better in the small areas, I think was clear better in offensive way that the last games.
And do you feel that something changed in the second half, or was it more Lahti that changed something?
No, I think at the end one team try to have more risky and the other ones try to be more reactive because they will get more spaces at the back. We wanted to keep the possession, but maybe the tiredness with some players, we suffer a lot with this and we had to do some changes for. But at the end, I feel that with the 1-0 we had some clear situations to kill the game, and we didn't. And at this level, the other team will not forgive you. And this, I think, is what happened with one. I think was talented action from Aduntayo, so made the 1-1, and after that was difficult for us.
Thank you. Probably, I don't know if you're from Iltasanomat. The incident at the end, how did you feel about the sending off? What did you feel that it was justified?
Oh, I feel that is there are four referees and three they can see that is a mistake, they have to solve it. So they have to solve it because it's a free kick for AF and they send out one AF player. So when four referees they cannot manage this, they have to take care. They have to take care because it's a wrong decision, as the coaches will do, but I think it's painful for us because we lost one player for another important game because we are not winning, and now you go to Goods with one player that received a fall.
Did you feel like it was very emotional at the end, lots of sort of back and forth with players from both teams? Did you feel like there was a risk that they may have lost control of the events, like everybody there? Like, did you feel like it was a threatening situation?
Oh, I think our team now is very motivated to show that we are able to compete at the league. We are facing well the teams, and today on the last part of the game, when happened this, that is not in our control, and the revolutions of the players, they are very high, can happen that. As well, sometimes it happened with myself, so I can expect that the players they can suffer the same, of course.
Thanks.
Okay, kiitos.
Kiitos.